People have been wanting this one for a while.
What's up, guys? Welcome to this episode of Beers and Breakdowns. You asked for it. We're finally doing it. Kurt and I are here in the theater to break down 12 Strong. So Green Berets breaking down a Green Beret movie.
Give the people what they want.
Give the people what they want. In all honesty, there's only a few things that really pop into our brain as questions. One major one.
In the room.
Giant elephant in the room for all Green Berets who watch this movie. You'll figure it out. Keep watching.
Line three, sir. You said line three?
Yes, sir.
Sound off. Joss. Jesus Christ. You got shit done on this one, huh? Was it confirmed? That's not my job to know where. That's your job.
Oh, wait. He does give him shit about his beard, though.
Yeah.
He does give him shit about his beard. Okay. Because he could be on leave.
He comes in. He is on leave.
He's on leave.
Okay. He comes in from vacation. He's like, yo, hey, I see what's going on. Like, what's up?
Oh, okay.
Fuck yeah, boy. I mean, we would have been.
If we had a fucking captain.
We'll be in this fight, boys. You mark my words.
Is it a meeting, sir?
It's a private meeting,
sir.
So the reason that would be so hectic is because the ODAs are all training for a specific mission, and this clearly changes all of that.
Yeah.
So now all the ODAs are scrambling to figure out what they need to know about Afghanistan, what the enemy is looking like. We're looking for any kind of information. We're trying to – all the teams are putting together anything they can to be the team for the job because it's a competition. We know war's about to pop off. You know only certain – number of teams are going to get the good missions.
Yep.
And it's like a fucking race to be like, hey, sir, we know exactly everything about Afghanistan now. We know who we're going after. We know what they need to do. And it's an intelligence race at this point.
Well, I think even here, though, is so early on, I don't even think like Afghanistan, like that might have been like one of the many that they thought of. But I don't think at this point, because you see the news, it's still on the TV. They probably weren't even 100% sure at this point. Mm. And so they're still just like, hey, just whatever's happening, I want to be part of that.
Your retirement papers?
There's nothing to submit, sir. I'm still Chief Warrant Officer of ODA 595, and my team has more combat experience than the rest of 5th Group combined. All that hell we went through in Somalia, Desert Storm, that means something.
So this guy, the warrant officer, just put in his retirement paperwork.
Yeah.
Like, could you imagine that? Like, you just put in your retirement. He's there 20 years, whatever, full career. And he's like, I'm getting out. And now he sees this shit. And he's like, I can't go anywhere. That's wild.
The crazy thing is, on my team, we had something similar to where the warrant officer was that valuable. Mm-hmm. That he was all the knowledge. He had multiple deployments. He was super... squared away. He was calm, cool, and collective. Losing him was a huge hit on our team because he had all the experience.
Yeah,
so
sure.
That warrant officer looking at these young men being like, they're about to go to war and I'm going to retire with my 20 years of SF experience and I'm going to take all that experience away from them when they're going to need it the most. So I 100% realistic that he would be like, I can't fucking leave these guys.
It's almost like a father figure at that point.
Absolutely.
I'll pull you a captain and get you in the game.
We have a captain, sir.
You have a captain with no combat experience. He's never been to war. He's only led you in training. He's already been bumped up to staff. This is a career wrecker. You understand that, right?
Well, all due respect, I've spent 2 years with that fellow leading our team. If you think furthering his career is why he joined, you need to get to know your captain, sir.
But if you guys are wondering, like, is that realistic that one guy would fight for another guy so hard? Absolutely.
Yeah.
So you have three in the head shed, and that you got your captain, your warrant officer, and your team sergeant. And those guys need to get along. They need to trust each other. So the fact that he's fighting for this guy, it makes all the sense because he likes them. They get along. Yep. So if you're going to go to war, you don't want to go to war with a team and all of a sudden some captain shows up and you fucking hate him. And now you guys are doing this the whole time. And, you know, butting heads and fighting. So, yes, you're going to fight for somebody you like, even if it's only been, you know, a couple years.
Just, yeah, it just shows the strength of their relationship and that he, the warrant officer, trusts him and like knows that he's a good guy.
Yeah. He's not in it to get promoted.
Yeah.
He's trying
Which
to leave.
Rare, man.
Yeah.
Oh, it's rare.
All officers, all they want is to get promoted. So the fact that he's willing to give up a promotion to go to war, that's a step backwards for him big time.
I had three in my time on a team, and only one of those was good. All the others were like career, like just worried about their own career and progression of their career. But the one, he was a good one.
Yeah, mine were not good. I almost had a good one, and he got killed, and I got taken off his team. He was awesome, but then I got taken off the Halo team where he was, and then I got put on a different team, and then the one I ended up with was...
Christmas came early, huh?
Oh, yeah. Ho, ho, ho. Where have you guys been?
Oh, we went to a fucking Nickelback concert.
How was it? Three panties on stage?
Nah. We got stuck in open position until the weather broke.
I hear the weather here doesn't change until June. Snowed last night to get used to it.
It was really?
Yeah.
Hey, what's all this?
Someone gave the quartermaster a gold card. Now the only unit with any cold weather tack gear is the 10th Mountain.
Oh, could you imagine when this popped off? It's like anything you wanted. You're getting.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
Dude, they told me when I, like, my senior, he was like, ask for whatever, dude, that whatever you need for this trip. I was like, let's get javelins. And he's like, they're not going to approve that. They approved the fucking javelins. We got four javelin missiles.
Damn.
I had the javelin out in combat. And my team sergeant was like, fucking smoke that cave right there. And I was like, ooh, bitch. I'm going to hit direct attack. And I, like, ran up. And then I got lined up, and then I'm like, I'm about to let out the coolant so I could fire it. And that bird comes in, and he goes, I think I see children in the cave. And my teams were like, can you confirm, like, you see children in the cave? He's like, well, no, but I can't not confirm.
Oh.
Like, what the fuck? Like, we knew we had enemy in the cave, and then he's trying to call them, like, children from the fucking birds. Like, come on.
Damn.
Dude. Completely squashed me using a javelin in combat.
Did you ever?
No.
Oh, man.
That was my shot, dude. I was going to direct attack that cave.
Anyone who tells you they've done this before or has experience in this is lying, sir. There's no playbook here. We're going to have to write it ourselves.
I briefed five potential captains for this mission. About 100 years of military experience between them. You're the only one that sees it the way it is.
So now they're in there trying to fight for the best mission. Again, like, this what being a Green Beret is all about. You're on your ODA. You have to try and get the best mission. Everyone wants it. It's for your pride. It's for all the glory. And you train your ass off, not to sit on your ass, but to go do the funnest mission.
Yeah. Right now, the captain is basically in the hot seat. He's representing the ODA. You got the captain here, and you got the warrant officer. And, you know,
somewhere there's a team sergeant, right?
You would think. Yeah. You would think he'd be somewhere. Where is the team sergeant? Like, I've seen the captain. I've seen the warrant officer.
Yeah.
The most important, like, cog in the wheel is just MIA right now.
Literally the most important person in the headshed is the team sergeant.
But, nowhere to be seen.
Yeah. And this movie, there's no team sergeant. No, they just don't have one.
They don't even mention him.
Yeah.
It's like they just erased him from the history books.
Completely said, we don't like him, get rid of him. The least they could have done is been like, hey, you know, we're a new team. We were, disbanding, and we don't have a team sergeant. Just mention it. But I can't imagine any team ever deploying without a team sergeant. Just give them an E8.
You can't have a team. You can't exist without a team sergeant.
The captain doesn't tell the fucking enlisted what to do, because he's got to worry about what he's doing now. You need to go win us the mission. You're not going to tell us what to do. You're not my fucking, like, supervisor. You're going to go try and win us the mission. The team sergeant's going to tell me what to do. We're going to do our jobs and work through him. And you sign papers. But in this movie, the fucking captain's the team sergeant, he's the captain, and you have a warrant officer. So it's just, there's no senior enlisted.
The captain in this, like, movie has like everything. Carte blanche to like just run the whole team, do whatever he wants to do, would never happen.
With his 2 years of team time and zero combat.
The warrant officer's been on, it seems like he's been on the same team since the early 90s, late 80s. And it's 2001 now, 11 years on the same team.
And he's got two wars under his belt.
Oh, they just landed.
Oh, they're linking up with the CIA operative.
The most dangerous part of any mission, normally.
Yeah, that link up's sketchy as fuck, and that got hairy quick. Put your fucking weapons
down! Drop your weapons! All that took was one person getting itchy trigger finger.
The fact that nobody pulled the trigger on the Afghan side, because they love pulling the trigger. Dude, we're in Afghanistan. We would send the Afghans in when we first got them. Like, they would fucking run in and we'd hear, ba-da-da-da-ow, ba-da-da-da-ow, ba-da-da-da-ow. Like, what the fuck? And you're in the back of the stack waiting to go in.
You're like, what's happening?
And you're like, fuck, dude, we're killing motherfuckers. And we go inside and they're all standing in the middle talking, ha, 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 you know. And I'm like, what the fuck? Did you guys kill somebody? What happened? Like, no, 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 clear by fire. And I was like, clear by fire? Who the fuck told you that was okay?
We didn't teach you that.
Yeah. They were legitimately going in and just going into rooms and going, brr, brr. And spraying fucking 7.62 in the rooms.
That's wild.
It's like, no. And like, it's not like this is your first time with an ODA. Like, somebody taught you the right way to do it. But hey, man, when you're fucking combat day in and day out, you come up with little tactics to avoid combat.
Yeah.
And spraying off rounds to let the enemy know you're on your way up and you're maneuvering towards them.
Yeah.
That's what they were doing. They're making all early this warning. Noise. Yeah, they're letting the enemy know, like, hey, we are coming, not the Americans, back out. You know, start your egress so we don't have to get in a real gunfight. Dude, craziness.
Could you imagine this, though, like, getting off the bird? That's you're the scary. First team in the country, right?
Yeah, I know.
And now you're sitting there, the bird leaves, everything goes silent, and you're just waiting, and you see the figures come up over. Like, that's a tense situation.
Yeah. Because there's all the air support isn't set up for you yet.
No, nothing none of set that up back for then. You.
Yeah, no.
You're the first boots on ground.
Yeah, so anything that happens, like, it's on you. You're on your own. And hopefully they can figure out how to, you know, come support you.
There, Mullah Razan's men.
Where?
You see the pickup trucks? Those are the Taliban.
Hey, you see the only fucking village within 100 square miles of where we're standing?
How's he like where?
Which one?
They got fucking tanks? Technicals? What?
Is it that mountaintop or is that group full of people? I can't tell which one you're talking
typical
about.
Typical fucking captain. Yeah. That's the most realistic part of the movie.
Point out which one. The bush or the 150 fighters down at the bottom of the valley?
I'm dropping these bombs from 30,000 feet. The plane doesn't guide the bombs I do. If I can't get close enough, I can't call in the exact location. Give me a little map.
Did your captain call in airstrikes?
No. Fuck no.
This guy is like a one-stop shop.
He does everything.
He's like all in one.
That's a good point.
He's a team sergeant. He's a captain. He's a CCT. Yeah, it's like all of it.
Dude, our fucking CCT only touched the air. Like, we had a Bravo that was it JTAC qualified?
Yep.
And he was like the backup fucking, like, don't you even think about it unless I'm dead.
The SOTAC guy, right?
Yeah. And so unless the CCT got fucking schwacked, don't you even think about talking to the air. That's his. He's got two fucking radios on. He's coordinating multiple fucking aircraft. Hell no. No one's calling it in but them.
God
damn. That's
ridiculous. I didn't come here to play around.
Check fire. We're way off. Stay here. I'll call back coordinates.
Where's Cap going?
I don't know. Coffers.
Getting closer.
So likely this is just a dramatization for the movie. Because I can't possibly see a Green Beret actually doing this. But you got your whole Afghan force, you have your ODA, and then the fucking captain's like, I'm John Wayne, I'm going to jump on a horse and take off down to get closer to a fucking position way down the mountain.
Not going to happen.
And now you have another Green Beret who's got to chase his ass, and then they send one commando with him.
Yeah.
And then now, so it's those three. And then what happens? There's a unit of Taliban immediately on that location, ready to fucking run them over. And now there's a huge separation and they have to come save them. So everyone's putting their lives in danger to go try and save the captain, basically.
Because of a rash decision.
Yeah, because he decided that he's going to be a fucking hero and go jump on his horse and ride his steed to the rescue.
Okay.
And they just jumped over the fact, like, how did you beat the tank?
He shot it.
With
he
what?
Shot it with his M4.
Oh.
On the three-round burst. You didn't see it?
Like, we just kind of skipped ahead of, like, all of a sudden the battle's over. The tank just fucking gave up somehow. And all those fighters are just dead. Like,
all the times fuck? I've seen this movie, I've never thought about
that. Yeah, like, where'd the tank go?
Like, it's just roaming around the battlefield. Yeah. It's fucking danger close.
Send it, dude.
Give it to me, baby. I need it. Clear it hot.
We've called in the danger close before. He argued with us.
The pilot?
Yeah. We're like, send it. He's like, you guys are too close. Can you please back off? No. Send it. And he goes, please. No. Send it.
Well, you got to think. That's a lot for the pilot.
It is. Don't like, fucking I'm dropping hit me.
This. Yeah, like, you want me to drop this? So danger close is, what, 250 meters or 500?
I have no fucking clue.
It's close.
It's too
it's
close.
It's fucking danger close.
It's dangerous.
I
felt the floor shake when the fucking rounds hit the ground. I was like, it was like, doo-doo-doo-doo. I was like, gosh, damn, that's close. It was so, like, impactful for us that I was like, there's no way they're alive.
Yeah.
And then they fucking lived. And then we get the video of them dropping it, which is the one that we posted.
Yeah.
And you see how far off that motherfucker was? And I was like, oh, damn, that's why he was so nervous. Because he was...
Oh, how far off the pilot was?
The pilot. So he's aiming for here. He was like, doof, 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 doof. It was like, wham, 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 wham. If that was off the other way, that would have been us.
Oh, damn.
So he was legit, like, saying, please, guys, I might hit you.
Fuck.
And we didn't know that until we saw the video of how off he fucking... Damn. He wasn't dialed in yet. All right, guys, so that wraps up this episode of Beers and Breakdowns with 12 Strong. Obviously, it's a badass movie. Yeah, there's things that they could have done better. It's not perfectly accurate. I don't understand why they don't have a team sergeant, but... Whatever. I think that the fact that, yeah, they have Thor and they want to make him a badass character, I think it does some injustice to ODAs to put so much emphasis on a captain. Mm-hmm. No captain ever gets that much fucking authority on a team. So you kind of pulled away from the ODA guys and the men who make the team by giving, you know, one person and making him a total badass. Like, you John Wick the shit out of Thor on the ODA.
They could have just made him the team sergeant.
Yeah, exactly. It would have been so much more believable if he was the team sergeant. But whatever. Other than that, it's a sick movie. I just, as a Green Beret, and I don't know about you, it's about the men. It's not ever about one person. And my biggest issue with this movie is that they made it all about one person. Like, there's one hero, and it's the captain. There's never one hero on a team. It's a team.
And it's not the captain.
And it'll never be the captain. If you do have one guy like in that, yeah, is going big, 100% probably won't be the captain. But, you know, things happen. All right, guys. Hope you liked that episode. Green Berets breaking down, you know, other Green Berets. Mad respect to those guys. They did huge things in real life. Wouldn't touch them, wouldn't ever say anything about those guys. Just know that our comments are about the movie and the movie itself, not the actual heroes that did these badass things. All right, guys, we'll catch you guys next time.